I'd turn that down if somebody said, Tana, do you want this jar? I'd say, oh, yeah.
Judging for the Madison County Fair for 2018 kicked off today, and we got to speak to a honey expert who was judging the beautiful entries.
Hey, did you know Wallingford Media Group develops, designs, and manages websites? Well, we do. Contact us soon for your brand new website, or let us give you a fresh new makeover.
I got into it, number one, because I love the taste of honey. Number two, I'm getting too old to pick up honey or supers, so I still wanted to stay in the honey business, so I became a honey judge. I look at the honey first and to make sure that it is very clean, because it is a food product. It has to be clean. Next is smell. Okay, first is look at it, clean. Next is smell. Is it fermenting? Is there moisture in it? If there's not, then the next thing I do is I taste it, and I want to make sure it tastes good. And if there's no foreign bodies in it. You can tell when a glass jar is full of real white honey that it is spring flowers. If it's amber, medium amber, it's later spring flowers. And if it's really, really dark, this one's a little bit darker, it's usually fall. I spend a lot of time explaining and trying to educate the public. The honeybee is in such peril that I want everybody to know when I come in to judge, I am judging everything that hive stands for. Madison County honey is wonderful. There is one jar here so far that is super exceptional so far. I haven't gotten to the other ones yet. I would love to see Madison County have more classes, mainly for wax, the show of wax, and candles, and creamed honeys, black jar honey, and that's really not an insurmountable goal to go for. But this participation's wonderful.
For more stories such as these, be sure to visit Richmond's very own WBONTV.com. And be sure to check out the Madison County Fair running this weekend and next through August 4th. For WBONTV, I'm Marissa Hempel.